everybody. Welcome to the Chronicles of Ruff series. It's gonna probably be like an 8-part series. On my trip to the Olympia. Right now I'm getting cardio done. It's something called MPA hit. So 45 seconds of this right here, steady state, 15 second sprints. And right now we're doing about 15 minutes in the morning. In the evening I do about 45 minutes steady state on the Stairmaster, so it's like the normal stuff.
None of that. I need my sleep.
Baby, how you doing?
About
the
it's like 11 o'clock at night here.
What you get the gym?
Home.
Oh, home. Hey, we filming. Say hey to all YouTube peoples.
Oh gosh, what are you doing?
Y'all, you look pretty. You don't gotta hide your face. Hey, but we gonna get going. I gotta start cooking, baby, okay?
Hey, my handsome baby. I love you.
I love you too, baby.
Thank you for calling me.
Okay. I'm back to the room. I used to play guitar back in the day. Guitar and bass.
I was a little bit better with bass, but you know, I don't get to it too often anymore. Let's see what else we got. You got my pro card. You gotta see what that looks like. Pretty cool. I'm a guy that likes to keep a lot of mementos and things like that. I have one of my favorite books, Rich Dad Poor Dad. All about the mind, man. You know, you'll fail if you don't have your mindset, right? But that's the beginning of every champion. A couple more matches. So. And we got a few posters here. First poster I ever was on. Really, really cool. And I believe... And this is like my other little wall. I keep everything. This is back when I was 19. I was 19 in a lot of these photos. Just starting out my bodybuilding career. Just getting together with my wife. I've known her for about 5 years now. Got married here. My mom gave me this as a present. Really, really cool. Funny story. I'm actually on like the first step. She's actually like 4 or 5 inches taller than me in that picture. But I got a few other things. Korean money, my wife sent me. My stepsister. This right here is back to one of my first entrepreneurial ventures. I used to sell belt buckles, you know, in high, middle school. I have a few other things, so, and we'll talk about it more later today, but this is back to a time when I was training for Special Forces TACB, and one of my first real failures as an adult, but it keeps me, again, grounded and remembered. It reminds me of what I can do, and if I put my mind to it. A few military things, a couple of achievement medals that I've gotten, a couple of coins that I've received. I got one of these. There was a helicopter crash not too long ago, and several, you know, soldiers, Marines, and airmen died. And I was actually a part of recovering the bodies and giving them their proper rights and putting them on the plane to be shipped out to their families. And it was a tough experience, but it was, I guess, very rewarding. Rewarding to be a part of that. Super sad stuff. So we're gonna move on to a couple other things. Nothing too fancy here. My mom and my godmother in Vegas. My mom's almost been to every show I've ever done, and I can't wait for you guys to meet her and everything like that. She's a bundle of joy, a bundle of joy. And this right here, just weird. Coca-Cola. I've had this for almost 10 years now. I don't know why. I just have it. I'm like, maybe I give it to my kids or something fancy. I don't know if I can drink it anymore. I feel like it'll probably kill somebody if they drink it. But, and the last two things on the thing is, I'm into comic books. I don't read a lot, but I got a few, and I'm looking forward to this movie coming out pretty soon too, next year, Black Panther. Let's see what else we got here. My wife likes Mortal Kombat, so she gets a lot of Mortal Kombat comics. But some of the things that we do in my free time. And just a little gag gift my wife gave me. I don't know what to do with it. I just keep it. But it's time to eat some breakfast, so. So, right now for breakfast, we're doing egg whites and grits, and that's it, really. Three packets of grits here. Yep. For the morning. I'm laughing at my microwave. I gotta call maintenance to get it fixed. I broke the door handle off. Cups of this. get this to caramelize. It's funny at work, they're like, what are you eating? Is that chicken? I'm like, no, it's eggs. They're like, oh, it looks like chicken. I'm like, that's cool, man. So I started getting ready for my first show in 2012. I saw a picture of Joel Thomas and Dexter Jackson, and I figured, you know, from that point on, that's, I was like, I'm focused on this. This is what I want to do. I was in Texas at the time, going through tech school for my job currently, and I remember that year was the first year I watched the Olympia, and I got so motivated by watching it. And I said, you know, as soon as I get to Florida, I got started before I moved to Florida. A lot of people say I need to be in a certain circumstance to be able to do bodybuilding. And I'm like, you just need to start wherever you're at. I can, you know, going through tech school in the Air Force, you don't get money for food because they provide it for you. So I was restrained to eating to, you know, whatever they cooked for me at that time. You know, luckily they always had chicken and things like that. But portion sizes and things like that, I didn't really know too much about at the time. So I would just get, the morning I would eat a big breakfast, grits and eggs like I still do now, or oatmeal, whatever was there. And then from there I would, you know, get my bag lunch for my shift. And I would eat first, and then I also take a bag with me. So I have something to eat while I'm going through the school and on our breaks. You know, I would eat it up real quick because I couldn't have food in the classrooms. And, you know, that's the way I did it for about 6 months. And from there, I picked up my first nutritional book. There's a little magazine called A to Z Nutrition. Again, Joel Thomas was on the cover. And it's funny, I met him like 3 years later and I told him that. And it's kind of weird to have that happen. But I picked up that book, and my first meal plan I did for myself was December 2012. I was at home waiting to go to my new base. I took some time off, and I decided, you know, I'm gonna get started right now. And the meals were really, really basic: chicken, broccoli, and rice. I had that for every single meal I cooked for myself, and the breakfast and dinner my mom cooked for that month. And that's what I did when I started. You know, I didn't know everything, but I knew enough, and I knew I could get started with what I had. From there, I got to my first duty station, Eglin Air Force Base, Fort Walton Beach, Florida. And I was there for about a month, or maybe a 2-3 weeks before I found the gym, you know, that I love, and it's called Gold's Gym. And I met a couple there, the Blacks, I guess. And I met John and Helen, that's their first name. And, they're a couple, they've been together for years now. And they were like the bodybuilding people in this town at the time. John was a national level competitor. He was placed in top 10 in nationals as a super heavyweight. So he was a big guy. And Heather competed in the past, but at the time she was just a nutritional coach with a pretty big team, about, I don't know, maybe 20-ish people or so. And they're very well respected in the bodybuilding area community. Yeah. And so, you know, I went to them and I told them, hey, I want to do this. And I told them I want to compete. It was 2013, January. I told them I wanted to compete at the end of the year, like in August or something. So I sat down with Heather and she talked with me. And she said, I think you should compete before then. I'm like, nah, I don't think I'm ready. And I think that's how most people are. They see themselves in a certain light, and they don't want to get on stage until then. But a lot of times when you do it that way, you end up never stepping on stage because you're never gonna be perfect. You're never gonna be how you exactly want to be. And so I usually encourage people to just hop up there, and from that point on, you have a specific goal. After that show, you have something very quantifiable and something to look forward to. And so she convinced me to compete in April, and we got started, and it was a really cool experience. Again, being a
an airman living in the dorms, I couldn't afford all the foods and stuff. So breakfast, three of the meals out of the day, I paid for myself. The other three or four, I had to use the mess hall or the cafeteria. And again, it's not always ideal, but you know, you do the best of what you have. And even with that, I didn't have a lot of funds to compete. And so a lot of people saying, you know, they say that I can't get started because of this, because of that. It's so expensive. And I just had a guy on Instagram, you know, talking to me about that. And I told him my advice was, you know, when I started, I did whatever I could. I told him, I promise you have something, you know, in your expenses that you don't need at the moment. When I started out, I didn't have internet. I didn't have cable. I didn't have a smartphone. I didn't get a smartphone until the Galaxy 5 came out. So that gives you a little bit of a, you know, history on that. And everything went towards bodybuilding because that's what was my goal and that's what I wanted to do. And I wasn't gonna let something like that, like finances, hold me back. I listen to a lot of motivational stuff, and a lot of them say the difference between a successful person and a not so successful person is a successful person says, you know, how can I do this? While the unsuccessful person says, I can't do it. They don't figure out a way to get something done. They just give up on that initial look. And I just feel like, you know, there's always a will. If there's a will, there's always a way. And so that was my first show. As you saw, I got fifth place in the open bodybuilding, which was last. But I did get second in the teenager class. I was 19 when I competed. And a lot of people, they get discouraged. They're like, oh, I got last, you know, I want to give up, I don't want to do this again. Or they'll just lie and say, I got fifth place, which isn't bad, which is also just as bad. But, you know, it really motivated me, like, unbelievably. Like, to the point where it was kind of, I cut off a lot of stuff. I was really focused and driven towards bodybuilding. I actually did nothing else. I would go to the gym at like 4 o'clock and wouldn't get home until like 8 or 9 o'clock at night because I was, you know, lifting weights, and then I would go and pose and I would do my cardio. And I spent a lot of time on posing. And I believe that's how, you know, why I'm so good now, because I would spend an hour a day posing. You ask a lot of the guys around here, I would be there in the posing room every single time they come to the gym. And, you know, 1 year later, I came back to that show and I won my class first place. I won the novice in my class first place, and I won the novice overall against a guy that was probably like 80 pounds bigger than me. He was at least like 200, 220. I was like 150 at the most. So that lets you know, you know, don't give up on that, you know, if you fell in the beginning. I see a lot of Starbucks. I just was watching something on Starbucks today, actually. And 252, I believe, was the amount of times the owner of Starbucks got rejected before he got a, you know, an acceptance for a loan for his business. Now, I don't know if I could lose 252 shows in a row and still be just as motivated, but that says something, man. It does. You have to have that determination, you know. But we're here. That was a good little talk. So what's up, everybody? We're here at Gold's Gym. As you guys know, this is the first episode of the new series, Chronicles of Ruffing, Olympia Bound. And with this episode, I really want to give you guys a chance to see how I got started and how I kind of got to where I am today. And that's why we're here with the man, the myth, the legend, John Blatts, my first mentor and trainer. So introduce yourself. And
like Terrence said, John Blatts. We're here at Fort Walton Beach, Gold's Gym. And this is where it all started for Mr. Terrence. There was a day that I was training a couple of clients. My wife was the fitness director here. She sat down and met with Terrence on a day and then introduced him to me and just said, hey, we got a young kid that has a phenomenal physique for an 18-year-old, and he wants to do a show. So that's kind of where everything started. We ran through some posing, and I feel like Terrence had a good idea that he knew that he was going to do real well, and it just kind of, everything fell in line for him from then on.
Okay.
Okay.
So I also want you to go a little bit into detail about yourself. How did you get into bodybuilding? I actually don't know the story. I never asked you.
I guess to be 100% real, it was just my own personal insecurities that fueled me to want to improve myself physically. I always played sports growing up through high school and in college. I played football, I ran track, did weightlifting team, and excelled in all that. And then afterwards, I got a job at a supplement store, and my coworker would just, talk smack to me every day, tell me that I was too small and I'd never get bigger, and just things like that, which, it gave me the push that I needed to excel in my weight training and my diet and making sure that I would be better than him and everyone else. And so that's kind of what fueled me. And then the first show that, Terrence did, and I did it back in 2009, was the Panhandle Showdown. And that was actually the first show that I went to in 2008 also. And then seeing people on stage also made me realize, like, man, I am small. I need to get bigger. And so that was my motivation, my fuel to continue training from then on.
Awesome. And, guys, I want to let you guys know, he also was a national level competitor, the top 10 in nationals, right?
Yep, 2013.
Yeah, so really top guy. From there, I just wanted, with the Panhandle Showdown, it was my first show, and he taught me everything I knew about, everything, with the training, the cardio, the diet, everything. It started here, and really, really grateful to that, and that's why I have you on this episode.
I appreciate it.
And so I remember you had a story about, you tell our people about my posing, for my first routine. I got a little bit of your help, and just tell people about how that went.
So if hopefully a lot of people that are following you and watching, they've seen you on stage, so they know how I'm like magnificent, I guess is the only word I can think of. But it's so phenomenal watching Terrence's posing routines, because he flows to the music, and the pro that I can think of is Melvin Anthony.
Yeah.
So with how he could flow and move, and we worked on it for the first show, and as y'all can see, I'm pretty white, so my rhythm isn't really too good. I know how to hit poses with different beats of music, but so we're practicing. It's show day. Terrence is prepping, and we come to the finals, and he goes out on stage and does his routine, and everyone's shocked, and it's amazing. And I'm standing there like, this ain't nothing we practiced.
I don't know what happened, man. I was doing it, and then I just felt like, oh man, I'm a big fan of, like you said, Melvin and Kai Greene.
Yeah,
and I was like,
yeah,
oh,
yeah.
I want to do something like them. And I just end up just completely flipping the script.
But it worked. It worked. So good.
And it was fun. I had a good time. And from that point on, I kind of stuck with that style. Another thing too is, when we first got started, you had a really big team, Team Relentless. Mm-hmm. Still got the sticker on my car right now. How was it like running, how was it running a team and stuff like that?
It was a lot of fun. And I think that was, I can't remember if you did, your first show was 2013?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so that was right around the time that the team was the biggest, I think, between everyone that we prep, men's physique, bodybuilding, bikini, figure. We had, I think, close to 30 competitors, and we won an award in 2012 at the Panhandle for having the best team that won the most categories, and it was a lot of fun. And I guess that was, having that camaraderie and having a team is what I missed the most about doing sports through high school and college. Mm-hmm. And it was good having it here, and it felt like that home atmosphere.
Yeah.
And then it was just, different career opportunities and things like that caused a lot of us to separate and do different things. And so I definitely miss it.
Yeah.
I miss having the team and everything, but it was good. We had some great, great competitors on it.
Yeah, I remember waking up on Saturday mornings doing the boot camps, and that was really fun. Getting together with everybody, and it was cool. Like you said, it's cool having a team and having people there, to support you, and you guys all working towards the same goal. And a lot of times now, it's kind of tough. You still do it, but not having anybody to talk to about bodybuilding is kind of kind of sucks, you know.
It does, and I can agree with that. It's become like such a solo sport. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, you can go to the gym and train with some people and things like that, and you know, the best training partner that I had never did any bodybuilding shows or anything like that. And then, but it is, it's, I can see where it's gone, like that selfish route, mm-hmm. which I know in the Pumping Iron and the Generation Iron movies, they kind of hit on that a little bit. And, you know, I want to get back to how it's, you know, everyone has fun and trains together. And it'd be good to be there one day, but it is, it's rough because it's a selfish sport. So mm-hmm. to be able to do well in it, you got to be a little bit.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. It's true. Shoot. Well, you know, I thank you for coming by and stopping and joining me for this interview. Mm-hmm. If you want to do any shout outs or anything else you want to do, anything else you want to mention, feel free to share it.
Yeah. Roughandready.com.
Oh, man.
Get all your clothing and your hats and your gear for training.
Yes.
Support Terrence. And then the other one that I got is just, it's Clean Eats in Shalimar. It's affordable food prep. They prep all your meals. They freeze them. They do whatever you need. They'll do low carb options, high protein options. And that's all I got. Okay. Heather Blatt's Real Estate.
Heather Blatt's Real Estate. Yes, yes. All right. Thanks, man. Thanks.
Yeah, I appreciate it.
Cool.
Pre-workout right here, I take Cellulol. I like it because it doesn't have any like stimulants in it. It's just straight to the point type of pre-workout. Mainly for blood flow and pumps. So if you're tired, this is not for you. But if you're not trying to get all jittery and you're trying to have a great workout, it's the best thing on the market. Do like 3 sets of this just for a warm up before I get started. Nothing crazy, get everything activated, and then we're really getting to our bad workout after that. Usually do about 10 pull-ups. I switch up my hand grips on the machine. I come over and do dips. Nothing fancy, just something I like to do.
Don't laugh at me.
Last set to make you a champion. That's what they always say, at least. Let's go. I'm gonna hit some rolls now. Good warm up set, man. Let's get started. Try to bend over more at a 90 degree angle, closer to like an actual bent over row. A lot of people these days, they say they're doing bent over rows, they're actually doing Gates rows. There's nothing wrong with it, it's just a different exercise. But if you really want to do bent over rows, and if you look at the guys like from the the 60s, 70s, all this time. You see these guys, they were bent all the way over. Yacy likes to stay more like at an obtuse angle. You know, it's a little different. You can lift more weight that way, but it doesn't activate the same muscles, you know? That's my little quick tip for the day. I love these old belts because they always been broken in. When I get I got a new belt and it's just like, oh, it's real rigid. Hurts my back really. So I like to start most of my workouts out with a very simple movement like a pull down. And then my second exercise is usually my big lift type of exercise, something heavier, you know, something like this. Just the legs, it'll usually be squats. That's what I usually like to do. I kind of got that from John Meadows. I really like his approach.
All right, say this out, man.
I don't like all the exercises. Okay, but I do like that approach to his training.
The YMCA, me and a couple of my buddies.
A little bit of my, you know,
I just want to let you know, watch these dishes. I've seen how you looked at the show and all that.
Yeah.
The way they judge that show or whatever and how you look, you know, versus the guys that was in, you know, higher place you, that was complete bullshit, man. That was complete bullshit. You should have had a better place than that, man.
Yeah, yeah, I appreciate it, man.
Yeah, man.
You can't do nothing about it. You just, let, you know, just keep going, man.
Yeah. I'm still, I mean, you know, you know,
got better arms than I do, man.
Man, I'm, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm glad to see you doing good, man. I mean, I'm glad to see your brother doing good, man, for real. I mean, you know.
Yeah, yeah, it's good to see you back here, man.
Yeah, I'm back here, so I just got back down here, you know. Past week, I wound up in the newspaper, you know, and I did a few things or whatever, and I mean, you know, you was one of the guys that, you know, I was like, yeah, when I was in Florida, I met somebody that was already on that level, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, with you, I mean, you know, you kind of set a standard for me, you know.
Oh, man, so, I appreciate it.
Just, you know.
Appreciate it.
So, yeah.
Cool. Say your name.
My name is Jay Gordon. I go by Jay King. I'm Chris Gordon. I'm competitive. I do the thing, you know, whatever, you know. So,
yeah.
Met my boy Terrence when I came into Florida last year, you know, and, you know, he made an impression on me, so glad to see you, man.
Appreciate it.
Keep doing what you're doing.
You too, man.
Thank you. I'm back down here, so might do something, you know, get back in the show or do something somewhere. All
right.
So, yeah, man. Good to see you.
Good to see you, man. Strap into this high chair, like I would, I like to call it. I usually finish up with something like this, something to put that muscle in a stretch position. You know, if it's bench press, it'll be like flies. If it's biceps, it'll be incline curls. No, just to give it a good stretch position at the end of the workout. So we're done in our back for the day. I'm gonna finish up with a little bit of arms. Usually after my back day, I hit the brachialis, and this muscle right up in here. You're already working it, you know, with all the pulling and the gripping that you're doing. So it's a good finish off on this day. You know. Three, four,
Lucky, man. A lot of people, the legs are the last thing to come in. It's like my legs are usually always pretty close to contest shit. Ooh.
Just finished training. I'll be about to throw in our post-workout meal for you guys. I get this from True Nutrition. Really, really good brand. And all the stuff is high quality. And the reason I know that is because they give you the option to have some of the low quality stuff. It's set up in a way that you can pick and choose what kind of proteins you want, whether it be, you know, protein made from bugs to protein, you know, the regular isolates like I have here. So we're doing two scoops, you know, of that. Next, we got cyclic dextrin. It's a very good form of carbohydrates. It doesn't spike your insulin as much as some of the other things like Gatorade does. And when you're prepping, you don't want those crazy spikes. One, two, and one more. Call this a secret sauce. Nah, it's just creatine. Nothing crazy. Their creatine comes in a weird container, like a plastic bag. And I don't like to carry that around. So I put it in one of my old other containers. So I come here. Usually at the beginning of my preps to kind of to get a focus and an idea of what I'm, you know, shooting towards, what I'm trying to be. This is a Herbert Field Air Force Base, and I came here back in 2012, 2011 time frame, and I was going through something called TACP training through the pipeline, and I was in the program for about, you know, 7-8 months, and it usually doesn't take that long. It usually takes about, you know, four-ish 5 months. But I actually was, you know, it was pretty tough for me going through this program. It's the special forces of the Air Force, and, you know, it's the best way to describe it.
And this is where I used to live. I used to live in these dorms here. I used to live right where that light is. Right in that room right there. It was a four-person bedroom. You know, very, very tiny. One fridge, one bathroom. We all lived together. You know, it was a good, it was tough, but it was a good time. But the reason I come here is, you know, because this is where I actually started my bodybuilding career. And it kind of brought me, it gave me the mindset that I have today when I compete. I went through this program, like I said, for about 7 months. Maybe either I got held back for failing something or I got injured, which is why it took me longer. And, you know, eventually by that 7 month, I ended up just not making it. And I was out of chances. I said, you're done. And honestly, I wasn't too upset. I was kind of tired. But it get, you know, going through this training, it let me believe that I can do anything. Like, I didn't think I would make it halfway as far as I did, doing half the crazy shit we did. I remember they would wake us up like 1 a.m. in the morning, bring us out here on this pad, that we, you know, rushing and doing crazy stuff, push-ups, sit-ups, you know, sprints, spraying water in our faces and stuff, everything was crazy. And, you know, doing all that stuff just really gave me a good outlook on life that, you know, this bodybuilding thing isn't that hard in respect, you know, to doing things like that. And I just like to come here, walk around, and remember those times to remind me that, you know, what I'm doing, you know, I can get it done. Whatever I want to do, I can do it. And it's not, you know, it's not the most difficult thing in the world. I just wanted you guys to see this. This is the tapping symbol here. There used to be a monument here to all the fallen airmen. And we used to do push-ups for each one of them on certain days. They since moved the school to Texas. But this is a really, really cool school. You know, so after filling out of this program, you know, I was waiting about 2 months to get my new job. And so they had me working right through that front door right here, something called CQ. And I would work, you know, midnight. I would work at nights, I think midnight to 4 a.m. or midnight to 8 a.m., something like that. But me and the guy that worked there, we would take turns going to a gym that was right over here. Just imagine, it's gone now because the gym was in a condemned dorm room, or dorm house. And they put, you know, the instructors had just put weights in there. And that's where I really got started, man, in an old, condemned, dirty basement. And that's where I learned all, that's where I got started. It was fun. And I enjoyed it. Really cool beginning, you know, to my bodybuilding career.